then footing column if you do with transient mixture, deduct 40% on the mixer machine rate. Beam mixer machine, with the mixer machine, 800 rupees per cubic meter, and beam with TM 50% less, you can see. Little bit more than 50%. Slab with TM 300 to 400 rupees per cubic meters, and floor column 1000 rupees per cubic meter. Staircase 1500 to 2500 rupees per cubic meter. Have you got it and write it already? Reinforcement. If dia is more than 12, then the rate is generally 4,500 to 5,000 rupees per ton. Whatever the rate is, you have to just focus on that you, like your labor knows very well that 500 will be less. Like if you are doing the reinforcement of dia more than 12, if you are using the dia more than 12, then the rate will be less like 4,000 per ton, like 500 less than the original rate. That means if dia is more than equal to 12, rate will be 4,500. Then if dia increases from 12, then the rate will be 4,000 per ton.
So which means the dia which is less than 12 is 4,500. Dia which is higher than 12 is 1400.
Yes. Why is this? Because labor has to cut the same labor has to give the same time to cut the steel. But if there are more cutting, like there will be same cutting will be there. But the if the dia is less than 12 and it is laid on like 1 square meter, then the weight will be different. Weight will be less than the dia when the dia is more than 12. That's why the labor is taking less rate for the dia is when the dia is more than 12. But labor is demanding that if the dia is less than or equal to 12, they will take more rate. Because the cutting is coming same, but they bill in kg, that's why they do this like this. Shuttering footing. For footing, 60 rupees to 120 rupees per square meter. Footing column add cost 20 rupees per square meter. Then beam cost same as column. Staircase add 30 to 50 rupees per square meter then column. Slab 150 rupees to 250 rupees per square meter. Then brickwork, internal wall 9 inch, one brick thick, 600 to 800 rupees per cubic meter. Internal wall 4 inch, 400 rupees to 400 rupees per cubic meter, like 40 rupees per square meter. We will do this we will see this thing in rate analysis, in detail. Then plaster is 12 mm, 80 to 120 rupees per square meter. 15 mm, add 10 rupees per square meter. Then marble 300 rupees per square meter. Tile 150 to 200 rupees per square meter. Woodwork 4000 per door. False ceiling gypsum board. With gypsum board 3000 rupees for 30 square meters. Then painting 100 rupees per square meter.
Okay.
Let me tell you the how you show the quantity takeoff of brickwork in Excel sheet. Okay.
Okay.
Because you have done only concrete part of footing and column, shuttering and concrete, but you have not done the that part.
Brickwork
and all. Yeah. Yes. Here it is. The format brickwork. Brickwork, you have to like you have to calculate horizontal 230 mm or whatever the thickness for like 200 mm thickness or 230 mm thickness, and another one is 115 mm thickness or 100 mm thickness. There are two bricks always, like right, like more thickness and less thickness, one brick thick or half brick thick, right?
Yes.
Then horizontal 230 mm, yeah, this is one brick thick. Then what you have to do, I'm doing like a sum up of all running meters. How much taking the how much is it taking the running meters? Like, let me show. Okay. With the drawing, with the help of drawing, I'm showing. Just wait. Here, this is 200 mm. This is 100 mm. This is 200 mm. Okay.
Yeah.
Or you can say 115. Whatever the architect is showing, 115 half brick thick. This is full brick thick. Okay. So what you have to do is take running meters of all full brick thick. Okay. This okay. Drawing, if you see, this drawing is making a mirror. Okay, this is making a mirror. If you calculate this portion, you can easily calculate into two. Yes, this is making a mirror. If you calculate this part, you don't have to calculate this part. Okay, so just multiply it with two. This is bedroom, same area. Okay, same length. This is full brick thick length. You have to take in meters, okay, running meters. So I'm showing this irrespective of taking this deduction of this ventilator. Okay, I'm taking full length first. Okay,
including the column,
including the ventilator, including the window. Okay. Uh-huh. Yes. Okay. So here I'm summing up of all the running meters of horizontal. This is a horizontal portion. These all are horizontal portions. Okay. And these all are vertical portions.
Okay.
These all are vertical portions. So in horizontal portion, full length brickwork also coming, and half brickwork thickness of brickwork is also, bricks are also coming. Okay, and for vertical length, vertical, there are also half thick brickwork coming, and there are full thickness of brickwork coming. Okay, full brickwork. So I am taking here horizontal 230 mm. I have sum up all the horizontal 230 mm. Then I have taken the ventilator portion in cubic meter. Why? Because mm-hmm. I will convert this value into cubic meter in future. Okay, in future columns. Mm-hmm. So I have converted this 600 by 600 ventilation portion with 230 mm, multiplying with mm-hmm. 230 mm thickness, because the full brickwork thickness is 230 mm. Okay, then I am showing it here window also 0.8 into 1 into 0.23. Okay.
Mm.
Are you getting?
Yeah.
Okay. Then door is 0.8 into 2.6 into 0.23. Okay. Then I am showing after deduction B2 minus C2. What have you done?
Because you didn't give the column yet.
Yes. This is the forget this. This thing you don't have to do. Take beam depth, then floor to floor height. Okay, that is 3. Okay, then brickwork height will be 3 minus 0.6.
Mm.
Whatever the beam is coming on the top of brickwork, okay, point the depth will be subtracted from the floor to floor height. Correct. Yeah. 2.4. Then quantity I am getting 15.6
mm-hmm.
into 2.4. Okay. Yeah. I'm doing total running meters of 230 mm coming, multiplying it with height, and multiply it with 0.23, I will get the quantity in cubic meters.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Correct. Then after deduction, I am deducting from this quantity. Mm-hmm. I am deducting ventilator quantity, window quantity, and door quantity to get the actual quantity of brickwork.
Okay.
Why I have shown this, I don't know, but let me delete this. This is not required. Yes, this is not required, I think. Yes. Okay. So this is a quantity takeoff sheet. It cannot be presented for claiming. Okay, this is just to show internal works of estimation, like in pre-construction phase you can show in internal purpose, circulation of internal purpose, like to show to your boss. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So vertical 230 mm thickness. Yes. If I'm taking the vertical 230, then horizontal 115 is like this, and I will do the same thing. Same thing will come for horizontal also. Mm-hmm. Okay. But I have to just think about here, because in square meter. Why? Because 115 is measured in square meter. Okay. But here 230 should come, because horizontal 230, vertical 230. Yes, sorry. Horizontal 115. Now you have to show the quantity in square meter, because this is half brick thick wall. Okay. So 3.15. Running meters coming, then ventilator I have multiplied it with 0.23. I'm removing it, because I have to show it in square meters. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
0.6 is the beam depth, floor to floor, 2.4 is the height. Okay, now I'm getting the quantity in square meter. What I have to do is 2.4 is the height and the length is 3.15, 7.56 is the square meter quantity of half brick thick. Okay, then okay. After direction, what I have to deduct from 7.56 is ventilator in square meter, window in square meter, and door in square meter. I'm getting 4.32 actual square meter quantity of brickwork. Got it?
In square meter, in cubic
meter. Yes. This is in square cubic meter. All values are same. Just I have removed the thickness part of here. Otherwise, the things are same. See here, 0.23 I have removed. So it can be converted into square meter. Okay.
Okay.
If you have any doubt.
No doubt.
Okay. I will mail you this sheet. Don't worry. Okay. So that you can do the work efficiently. Have I mailed you the brickwork drawing?
No, I don't think I have received.
Just wait. Have you received this file, C1?
Yeah, I have received the drawings.
Yes. So you have to work on the Excel sheet and take off all the brickwork quantity, okay, plaster quantity, and this is the flooring area you have to calculate. Okay, show it in the Excel sheet. Okay. And yes, brickwork, plaster, then number of bricks, sand, quantity of sand, quantity of cement. Okay. Putty, paint. Okay. Plaster, putty, paint. Okay.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. And I have told you the rate also, sand 30 rupees per CFT. Cement 300 rupees per bag. Okay, already I have told you 300 rupees per liter paint, and putty 70 rupees per kg.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Okay.
So do this this thing also, and now let's come to the labor part. Now we have done the we have taken the assumption that these are the rates, like we have experienced the rates. Okay, we have seen the rates, all the things, what rates are takes the labor team in different for doing different works. Okay. Now the labor productivity. This is a very important technique and very well used in at construction site. If you are deputing any labor, okay, labor team, okay, you just suppose you have 10 mason, 20 labor, then how will you target the quantity? Like how will you decide in your mind that if there are four front, then what will be the quantity of target you will give to your labor team? Like if you have the front of RCC, PCC, brickwork of some quantities. So these are the situation we will see. Okay. Costing productivity. First technique is costing productivity on the basis of market rate of general civil work. I have already told you earlier. Recently this market rate of general civil work, then costing productivity on the basis of market rate. What is this technique? How this technique is used? I'm telling you this example, labor deployment planning as per budget. Okay, suppose you have a front of RCC 30 cubic meter, PCC 10 cubic meter, brickwork 10 cubic meter, plaster 50 square meter. and you have a group of labor, 15 a team, 15 mason, 30 labor, and one mason cost rupees 600 per day, and labor 300 rupees per day. Okay, so 15 mason, 30 labor. What amount you will be giving? You will give 18,000 rupees to them after passing one day. Okay, so you are investing 18,000 rupees. So you will expect that I will cover 20,000 rupees work from this team, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so how will you give them target? Okay, there is one technique. Like I have already told you, RCC is 800 rupees per cubic meters market rate, right?
Yes.
PCC 450 rupees per cubic meter, brickwork 800 rupees per cubic meter, and plaster is 120 rupees per square meter. So for RCC, what you are getting, if you give 10 cubic meter target, you are completing 8,000 rupees work.
Yes.
Okay. And if you give target of 10 cubic meter of PCC, you are covering 4,500 rupees target.
Yes.
Okay. And if you give 10 cubic meter, you are covering 8,000 rupees. So 8 plus 8, 16 plus 4, 20,500 it is making. Okay. So that means it is bigger than the 18,000.
Yeah.
So you can easily say that as per the market rate, okay, not as per that one mason, one labor does RCC this much, then you are giving the target. No, this is a very wrong technique. Why? Because if you work, construction projects has different geographical location. There are different rate variation. Okay, labor takes higher. Some area labor takes higher than if compared to another area, and they do less work. They charge higher and they do less work. Okay, so so we must consider the area also. What area we are working, where our project is going on, which location our project is going on. So if we are taking that one area location is these rates, we are taking these rates of particular location. So the bill is making this. So we are satisfied that whatever the output will be, if our labor does RCC 10 cubic meter, PCC 10 cubic meter, brickwork 10 cubic meters, then our owner will be satisfied. My boss will be good with it. Okay, this technique is originated by Bhadanis only, and you cannot find in any book like they are telling you with these things. They just print the one mason, one labor does this amount of quantity, this much of quantity, this one mason, the one labor does brickwork of 10 cubic meters. Oh, sorry. One mason, one labor does 1.5 cubic meters. Okay. I will mail you these things also. Don't worry. You will learn the constants also, but without having the constants. Okay. How will you do any task at construction site? This is the technique.
Okay.
Now try to depute in future your future contract projects with these techniques. Okay, depute this. Yeah. Your owner will be happy. You try to show the let me show you the sheet also. Labor productivity sheet. Wait. Like this, you will show like brickwork cubic meter, RCC cubic meter, like brickwork 12 cubic meter. You have front like this. 1867. Okay, you have skilled labor like mason. Skilled labor is called mason. 7 labor, unskilled labor, 18 labor, 18 unskilled labor. Then what they are taking from you, the 9600 rupees amount. Why the skilled labor is 600 and unskilled labor 300. I have multiplied with the quantity into rate. Okay, then I have shown the market rate. What is market rate here? 800 rupees. Then the market amount will be 9600. Means if you take the help from another group on measurement, so they will take the, they will make the bill of 9600. So your productivity is showing nil. Like nil means zero, means no loss, no profit. Means they have done as per the market standards. Your labor productivity is as per the market standard for the brickwork on that day, on that particular day. Okay, I have subtracted the market amount with the actual amount we have given to the to our laborers. Okay, so for RCC I have done 18. I am getting 5400 productivity rupees. 10,800 will is the amount I have given to my labor. But if I outsource this work to another party, they will take around 16,200. So I am getting the profit, but I am getting the loss in plaster work. 67 square meter. 9 I have deputed 9 masons, 20 labor. I have given 11,500. I have spent 11,500, but if I outsource the thing, I will have to pay only 8,040 rupees. So overall I am getting productivity profit 2,040 rupees. Okay. Got it. So I will mail this sheet also. Don't worry. You will work on it and try to find out all the quantities and try to find out the labor requirement also for that from that sheet. Okay. Try to find out find out the labor costing, material costing, and add all those costing and let me know that how much quantity and cost is coming. Okay. This is your task.
Sure.
So for today, let's call it a day, or you want to go further?
Yeah, I think we can do a little topic, another little topic.
Okay, no problem.